Good day guys, and welcome to my YouTube channel. Before I start this video, let me make this known to you that I have another interface of Microsoft Office here before me, which is Microsoft Office 2016. I have been using Microsoft Office 2007 from the beginning of this tutorial. I upgraded to Microsoft Office 2016 due to the fact that it has more functions and interface compared to Microsoft Office 2007. Alright, from this moment, I will be using Microsoft Office 2016 to perform this tutorial. However, I employ everyone who is using Microsoft Office 2007 and below to upgrade to 2016 and above in order to have more functionality of Microsoft Office interface. Thank you. Alright, so let me start this tutorial. In my last video, I talked about formatting pivot table in order to give your pivot table a beautiful interface. Today, we are moving into another features of Microsoft Excel Power Pivot Table called Drilling Down into Pivot Table. This is just a reverse of Pivot Table, of what Pivot Table is all about. Alright, if you remember in my previous video tutorial, in which I make use of data list to create pivot table, which I have been using throughout my pivot table video tutorial. Here before me is another detailed record of over 10,000 plus of data lists here, consisting region, country, item type, sales channel, unit sold, unit called, total revenue, etc. All right. So let me summarize this details record using pivot table. Okay, if you still remember in my previous video, before you can summarize this detail data list on the pivot table, the first step is to select anywhere on the interface, then click on insert. So once you click on insert, then you will see a pivot table there. Click on pivot table. Now I want my pivot table to be what, to be created on new worksheet. All right, so just click on it. Okay, just click on it. All right, you can see that my pivot table have been created on a new worksheet. Let me name it this to be what, pivot table drilling. Summary. All right. So now I'll be able to create a pivot table now. So now let me build this interface with the data list I have here on this pivot table field. Okay, now let me build the country. Let me put the countries here, the country. So you can see that I'm building the pivot table step by step. Now let me try to, I want to know the total revenue in respect of, let me put, okay, let me know by type. All right, you can see that I'll be able to build this pivot table based on this details pivot table list here before me. So you can see that I'll be able to build this pivot table into what, with this pivot table data list here. All right, so okay, let me change the currency format here, so that in order to make it look more beautiful. So as we rightly said on our previous tutorial, so just go to your value fit setting here, then choose the number format then you can then choose the currency, just leave this, the other default numbers, then click on what. Okay, automatically I'll be able to what, change the what, the currency, the currency to into dollar. Now I want to move away from the details, because I will now want to create a report that I can look at, maybe compare items, maybe compare items type with against one another, with maybe countries and its total revenue here. All right, to in order to know if there is increase or decrease in revenue over the year with this raw detailed data, probably which might not be easily accessible to get to that point. Now I got my pivot table here, and now I can now summarize these details with quick and intelligent basis to make a better decision based on this summarized data. All right, however, there is going to be an occasion where you now want to drill into this summarized data to see the details. For example, with this summarized data before the data list before me here, I might like it want to know why this baby food here having, okay, let me see, okay, let me use Angola, having 9,432,085, having the highest number of sales revenue in Angola. So how do I do that? You can see that Angola having the highest number of sales revenue, which is 9,432,085.44 dollar. And so I want to see the details behind this sales revenue amount. This is another simple features in Microsoft Excel pivot table called drilling down. However, I'm going to drill down into this detail of that value. How do you do this? It is by just double click on this value represented by what, Angola baby food, represented by what, Angola. Now if you just double click on it, you can see that now baby food amount in respect of what Angola has been reviewed, well, which has been able to be summarized with pivot table. Now I can see everything that baby food sales revenue comprises by drilling down into the details of that summarized data. It is really easy to do, and not more than that, but very quick and accessible way to get back to the details of your summarized data with this simple technique. I don't need to filter for baby food details in order to source the data sheet by modifying the original list before I can see baby food figure. Why should I have to do that? No, I don't need to do that. So with this quick and easy way, just double click on the summarized detail in the pivot table section, right, then drill down into those summarized data, then you are done. Try this out with this simple double click and you are done. Thank you, and don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel, so I'll keep giving you more of the updated exam this function. Bye.